Hey, what's up everyone? My name is Rehman and today we are going to talk about cryptocurrency crash, some reasons behind it and what's gonna happen next, and also gonna look at some coins as I mentioned in the description or title of the video. So let's start the video, and first of all we're gonna look at the market, what's going on. Bitcoin is at 41.9k at the moment. You can say 42k, it's just now on 42k. And now look at here, oh my god, everything red sea, red from our blood, from our money, which is gone now. Overall, the global crypto market cap is 1.7 trillion, minus 3.35% decrease over the last day. That's insane amount of numbers, I can tell you guys. And also, the reason behind it is said as Evergrande, China's biggest, like you can say second largest real estate company. They are saying that that is associated with this crash. But even if it is associated, I don't think so. People are selling, people are panic selling because of that news. There must be other things involved in this, because now we are used to these type of news of FUD. I don't think so. This huge crash is just because of that Evergrande's news, or like obviously it affected also cryptocurrency and all the market, but not this much. Like Bitcoin is on 40,000 at the 42,000 at the moment, and I don't think so that that FUD is the only reason of this crash. There must be other reasons also. And look at this picture here, Hobby is on the top, and on third it's Binance. The liquidations, it's insane amount of liquidations. Total numbers are like mind-blowing. And believe me, I'm not checking my portfolio. I did not use stop losses, and I know what's going on in my portfolio right now, so I'm not checking it so I don't get panic. But I'm not gonna sold after this. People are panic selling and they think it's the end of bull run, everything is done. Even though there are many believers, there are professionals, people saying that no, this is not a bull run, or we are going in bear market. But the thing is, there are a lot, I do a lot of research, I read articles, I check YouTube videos, check out what professionals are saying, all the stuff. And this type of crash was, you can say, expected. To be honest, I heard the news that September is going to be red even before September, and I was like, okay, let's see, I'm not gonna sell my bags no matter what. And that happened, and my resources were like legit, so that's why. But now the thing is it the end? People are selling crazy, new buyers are selling, but I don't believe this is the end. I think this is not even the start. Yes, no doubt we are more closer to 10k instead of being closer to 100,000 Bitcoin, which were the predictions. Like at the end of the year, Bitcoin is, some were saying Bitcoin is going to be on $500,000, some were saying on $150,000, and these predictions were realistic. You have to believe that. Even I was expecting Bitcoin to cross $100,000 at the end of the year in December, and I still believe it can happen, but not a financial advice, just like estimate. That this is not the end. This FUD news and also the crash, you can see everything is red now. My heart hurts by seeing this. That's why I'm not checking my portfolio at the moment totally. When I woke up today, I checked some messages from some friends who are in cryptocurrency, and I knew something has happened. I thought, okay, maybe, hope so, it's something really big. Bitcoin crossed 1 million, but it was nothing like that. Bitcoin was on 40,000 at that moment, and Cardano was on $2, 2.0 or something, because I have some big bags of Cardano. Everything is down. And if we check out Solana, which was making so much hype like some days ago, it's minus 10% at the moment. You can see $128 is its price, and it was on $200 some days ago. And also Polkadot, $28. Everything is down so bad. We can't say this coin did good, this coin is not that much down. It affected each and everything. And about Cardano, I really want to say that I knew that it's risky. Prices can shoot up also, but prices can stay down. When Alonzo smart contracts was launched and announced on previously, but I did not sold my Cardano bags at all. Just sharing my stuff with you guys that I am in Cardano, in this project ADA, for a long term, for a long run. and I really believed smart contracts launched, but it's not in use yet. So people really like were saying why it's not like Moon and all those things. So smart contracts can't be used at the moment. I hear that, I read that out. It will be used after some dates. I don't remember the exact dates, but this is the case. So I think Cardano will be really huge. HBAR, you can see it was showing some really, really big gains just like some days ago when I was checking, and even it's down 8% at the moment. But I really love this project. I believe in this project and I think it can be really big in future. And HBAR, it touched 0.55 cents, so so I think it can really cross that too. And in future I love this project, like I am in this in Cardano. And one which I'm skipping is XRP. Even though I love that project, I believe it can be really big, but for some reasons I'm not in it as much. I'm in Cardano, in HBAR, or in VRA, Veracity coin. Let's check out Veracity coin also. Veracity coin, you can see 0.029, well, not that bad. I'm not so much disappointed from this one. This is can't say a new project, but an early one. You can say its rank is 349. I am in this one also, so I thought I should mention this. And there are some more, I can't mention all of them, but this is what's going on. And I think we are in a very bad zone. Bogdanov dumped us again, but I think I'm not gonna sell my bags soon. I'm a long holder in altcoins, in cryptocurrency. So I'm not selling my bags at all. In these type of times, I drink coffee or juice or whatever I have, and don't look at my portfolio so often. I will check out my portfolio when things will be mooning again, like Bitcoin on 55k. Then I will open it and check how much gains I made. Till now, it's closed. I don't want to see a red big line going down. So these are the things going on. Evergrande, they are saying, is the reason behind the crypto crash, and also yes, it is the reason behind it, but I don't think so. Like, we should put all on Evergrande. There must be some really big complications and other things involved in it too, obviously. And you saw the liquidations. Oh, that was huge. So these are the things I wanted to share with you guys, what's going on and what's next. And next, I think it's gonna rise. It's not the end of bull market. If you check out the previous patterns, this one is similar to that, and we are like in this zone. We are gonna go like this soon, but this is not a financial advice, just what I think I'm sharing with you guys. So that's it for today. I will see you guys in the next video. Take care.